We don't know if the king is going to watch this series. I can tell you that he's watched previous series of The Crown and, you know, and enjoyed it. I think the last series was a little too close to the bone for him as well.
Camilla is who I want. That is where my loyalties lie. That is who my priority is.
I suspect he won't be watching this. I think all of it's going to make for very uncomfortable viewing for the king, for any member of the royal family. But I do suppose that moment when she steps out in the revenge dress, I mean, that was just such a low moment for the royal family. Charles admitting adultery, you know, this was the sort of, the War of the Wales is being played out in spectacular fashion in the tabloids. And then on camera in different interviews. So I think it's probably an awkward moment whether or not the king's going to get to see it. Well, we may never find out.
The royal family is in genuine crisis.
Have royal scandals damaged the country's reputation?
I suspect that even if the royals are not watching, certainly people who work at the palace absolutely will, because there's a big curiosity factor about this series. And it's had so much media hype that I think it's just going to make more and more people want to watch it out of curiosity, if nothing else. I think we'll all be watching the Bashir scenes very, very closely, and I suspect the palace lawyers will be watching those scenes very closely. We now know how Martin Bashir procured that interview. We know how he preyed on Diana's insecurities and her paranoia that she was being spied on. Prince William has made it clear he never wants that interview screened again, and the BBC has promised that it will never be screened in its entirety. So for it to be reenacted in The Crown, I suspect out of everything, in all of the plot lines, that was probably one that the Crown's lawyers were watching very, very closely. And as I say, I suspect palace lawyers will also be watching very closely.
She opens her mouth and hand grenades come out. She wants to tear down the temple.
Let's go for it.
What the hell is she doing?
Well, I've no idea if Harry's spoken to Dominic West, but I think certainly for Dominic West going in to that role, playing Charles during some of the most tumultuous years of the royal family, and let's be honest, a time when Charles's popularity was at absolute rock bottom, I think any actor would jump at the chance, because obviously it's a wonderful opportunity, but probably also think twice about it as well. I mean, when they were making The Crown, they would have known, given the Queen's age, given her frailty, and that, you know, she wasn't going to live forever. And therefore, there was always a very real risk that this series was going to go out when she was either close to death or indeed had died, as is the case. And so I think that is a big responsibility for the actors. For them, it's a role. But of course, the problem with all of this is it's not just a role, it's not just a character, it's not just a part, it's a real person who now happens to be king, and it is the dredging up of a past which he'd much rather move on from.